Blog Talk Radio.
As an ex-atheist, I looked at the proof and evidence that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and I am now a Christian. Behold the proof and evidence that Jesus Christ is the Son of God, and the Bible is the Word of God. Let's see if I can do this in about 4 minutes. As the Son of God, prophesied, fulfilled. As the seed of the woman, prophesied, fulfilled. As the seed of Abraham, as the seed of Isaac, as the seed of David, his coming at a set time, his being born of a virgin, his being called Emmanuel, his being born in Bethlehem of Judea, great persons coming to adore him, the slaying of the children of Bethlehem, his being called out of Egypt, his being preceded by John the Baptist, his being anointed with the Spirit, his being a prophet like to Moses, his being a priest after the order of Melchizedek, his entering on his public ministry, all these prophecies fulfilled. Coincidence? Let's keep going. His ministry commencing in Galilee, prophecy and fulfilled. His entering publicly into Jerusalem, his coming into the temple, his poverty, his meekness and want of ostentatious, his tenderness and compassion, his being without guile, his zeal, his preaching by parables, his working miracles, his bearing reproach, his being rejected by the brethren, his being a stone of stumbling to the Jews, his being hated by the Jews, all of this prophesied and fulfilled. His being rejected by the Jewish rulers, that the Jews and Gentiles should combine against him, his being betrayed by a friend, his disciples forsaking him, him being sold for 30 pieces of silver and his price being given for the potter's field, the intensity of his sufferings, his patience and silence under suffering, his being smitten on the cheek. Coincidence? Let's keep going. His visage being marred, his being spit on, scourged, his hands and feet being nailed to the cross, his being forsaken by God, his being mocked, gall and vinegar being given him to drink. All this was prophesied and fulfilled. His garments being parted in lots, cast for his vesture, his being numbered with the transgressors, his intercession for his murderers, his death, that a bone of him should not be broken, his being pierced, his being buried with the rich, his flesh not seeing corruption, his resurrection, his ascension, his sitting on the right hand of God, prophesied, all this prophesied and fulfilled. His being the chief cornerstone of the church, his being king of Zion, the conversion of the Gentiles to him, his righteous government, his universal dominion, the perpetuity of his kingdom. And I'd like to add one also. When Jesus said, when I am lifted up, I will draw all men to me. I will confess that I used to be an atheist. I cannot rationally, logically, look at the astounding amounts of evidence, and this is just a very small percentage of it, and proof that is in front of my very eyes, and deny Jesus Christ is the Son of God. God bless you, and Maranatha.
Ray, we're so excited to have you here. Your book, You Can Lead an Atheist to Evidence, But You Cannot Make Him Think, is getting rave reviews. I want to read something to our audience here. Just going through the reviews here, Kathleen Nielsen said, once I began to read this book, I could hardly put it down. Well thought out book with great tips for witnessing to atheists. The information this book should make, and she put should in all caps, should make an atheist backslide If not, I would have to assume they just love to wallow in their sin. Michael McLeod also gave it 5 stars, saying, Ray's writings are among the very best in the world today. He disproves every dumb atheistic assertion very simply with both scientific fact and common sense. The book is sure to enrage the atheists and seculars of the world, but their anger and 1-star reviews are only proof that they are not losing, that they are losing the argument. But it says atheists don't exist, and it is proven over and over again in this book, as even the most feeble-minded know in their minds and their hearts that there is obviously a creator. He goes on by saying, let's go to the next one. He has a really long review, 5 stars. I'll read one more by, it says, a General J.C. Christian, patriot. Looks like it's someone in the military. Dr. Comfort's book is amazing. It may be the best primer for defeating an atheist I've ever read. Really, really good. Ray, it looks like you got a hit here. Tell us about your book and why you decided to write it and how things are going.
Well, did you read those from Amazon.com?
Yes, I did, sir.
You'll
That's exactly
find
where
about
I got
200 reviews from atheists saying it's the worst book that's ever been written.
That's how you know it's, you know the saying where it says if you throw a stone into a pack of dogs, the one that yelps the most is the one that got hit. It appears this is also a hit with the atheists. It seems to have struck a nerve.
I think so. But it really is true that the title isn't meant to be sarcastic or cynical. An atheist just doesn't think. All you've got to do is look around you and look at the incredible creation that we live in, and then ask an atheist, can you make me a frog from nothing? Or could you make me a bird from nothing, or even a leaf or a grain of sand? Our most intelligent scientist hasn't got a clue how to make a grain of sand, let alone a living seed that'll reproduce after its own kind, let alone something with a beating heart and blood vessels and liver and kidneys and lungs and eyes. And so how intellectually dishonest is it to say this whole wonderful creation came into being without a creator? It makes no sense. So I've been saying to atheists when I meet them, so you believe nothing created everything, which is totally unscientific. It's impossible scientifically. And they say, often they'll say, no. So do you think then something created everything? I say, yeah. So you're not an atheist, you're agnostic. Do you believe that something was intelligent? And most of them say, yes, I believe you. Whoever or whatever it was intelligent. So these people really don't think deeply about what they believe. They've just grabbed onto a philosophy that gives them a license to fulfill their own sinful desires. That's the basis of it.
Well, you know, I had asked Conservapedia.com, because they had some really good information on you and also your book, if I had their permission to use some of the information on their site, and they said yes. So I want to thank Conservapedia.com. It says, Ray Comfort, this is what it says about you, Ray. All good, of course. Ray Comfort is a leading Christian apologist. He has written large number of books on evolution and theology, including Evolution, A Fairy Tale for Grown-Ups, and How to Know God Exists, Scientific Proof of God. His latest book, which is the one we're talking about here, You Can Lead an Atheist to Evidence, But You Can't Make Him Think, knocked Richard Dawkins' book, The God Delusion, off the number one spot in the atheism category at Amazon.com. Ray, we pray for Richard Dawkins. You know, we don't agree with him. But he seems to be very upset about getting knocked off. I want to tell you, I found an audio. I want to play this for you. Ladies and gentlemen, tell me if you sense a little bit of anger in Dawkins' voice here towards my friend here, Ray Comfort. Listen to this. And congratulations, by the way, by knocking Dawkins' book off the number one slot, Amazon.com. Listen to this audio, ladies and gentlemen.
Written in about Ray Comfort. He's an evangelical Christian. He's got very different views from you, opposite views, you could argue. He's asking, how can Darwin's Origin of Species be refuted in 54 pages, which is effectively what Mr. Comfort's trying to do, isn't it?
There is no refutation of Darwinian evolution in existence. If a refutation ever were to come about, it would come from a serious scientist, not an idiot.
Well, if he says a flower is based on God's creation and you say it's through evolution, then he's got a right to that opinion as
you much asked as you. Me a moment ago for my hunch, and I said hunches aren't interesting, hunches aren't valuable, what's important is scientific evidence. It doesn't matter what Mr. whatever his name was, Comfort, what his opinion is, it doesn't matter what my opinion is, what matters is the evidence. The evidence is absolutely clear. The evidence is in favour of evolution.
Okay, and Ken's question is, how does evolution prove there's no God?
Well, it doesn't. You can't prove there's no God. You can't prove there are no fairies. You can't prove there are no leprechauns. You can't prove that Thor and Apollo don't exist.
Wow. He sounded a little upset there.
Yeah, that's usually the way. Let me just talk about Richard Dawkins for a moment.
Yes, he seems upset, Ray.
He does. Well, I can understand why he's upset. We gave out 170,000 copies of Origin of Species to 170,000 university students in 100 of the top universities in the U.S., myself and about 1,200 other committed Christians. And he was pretty upset because we gave the opposing view to his belief. And not only did we give them out here, we sent 1,000 to his own hometown, to his own home university, Oxford University, and I sent personally hand-delivered a basket of fruit but with a banana in the top. And a
very good.
And I didn't say who it was from. I left it to him to formulate his own theory as to its
that
origin.
That is so good.
And so that's probably why he's a little upset, I'm sure, because he does know who I am. He's mocked me quite often, so to make out he doesn't know my name shows there's something stirring in him. But Dawkins,
right.
He's not pro-evolution. He is anti-God. His agenda is to turn people against God.